lymphoma. Now, as you all know, lymphoid organs are of two types, central and peripheral, whose the organs which are located centrally, like thymus and bone marrow, they are called central, and peripherally, lymph nodes, spleen and mucosa associated lymphoid tissue and gut associated lymphoid tissues are seen. Now, this is the normal histology of the normal cells which are present in the lymph nodes and other lymphoid organs. First and foremost, the most precursor lesion is the immunoblast. This is the immunoblast. This one, this is the immunoblast. Here you can see a large size cells there with abundant cytoplasm. Nucleus is there, which is also large, and a prominent nucleoli is seen in the nucleolus. In the histopathology view, you can easily appreciate the amount of cytoplasm here, nucleus, and this is the small nucleolus in the nucleus. Then they will mature into follicular, then other cells which are present in the lymph nodes are the follicular dendritic cells. These cells are there in the lymph nodes which maintain the follicular germinal centers. So they are also large in size with eosinophilic nucleoli. Now, next, from the immunoblast develops the large non-cleaved cells which are called as centroblast. Now, you can easily identify the difference between immunoblast and centroblast. In immunoblast, cytoplasm was abundant. In centroblast, cytoplasm was not there. And instead of one, there are three nucleoli. One, two to three nucleoli are there. These then centroblasts develop into centrocytes. Centrocytes are small cleaved cells. This is very important, cleaving. You can easily identify there is a cleaving in the nucleus. Nuclear cleaving is seen, and these are smaller than the centroblastic cells. Then they will develop into the mature lymphocytes, which we all know. These are small cells with... Now, next slide. Now, this is the neoplastic proliferations of white cells. As you all know, white cells are being divided into lymphoid cells, myeloid cells and histiocytic cells. Lymphoid cells, you all know, they are of B cells, T cells, NK cells, which will develop into lymphomas and lymphoid neoplasms. Myeloid cells, these are the granulocytes in the blood. You can easily identify them in the blood. They will develop into acute myeloid leukemias, myelodysplastic syndromes and myeloproliferative neoplasms. These are the three categories of myeloid neoplasms. This you will cover in the detail in your hematology section. Now, lymphoid and myeloid, other than these two neoplasms, histiocytic neoplasm are also comes in the classification of white cells. These are the proliferative lesions of macrophages and dendritic cells. Okay, next slide. Now, what is the difference between leukemia and lymphoma? This is a general term you all must be knowing. Whenever the reports come, there is written leukemia or lymphoma. Leukemias are the neoplasms that present with widespread involvement of bone marrow and all, of course, the blood. So, if then the cells are present in the blood and bone marrow, then these are called as leukemias. When there is proliferation of these cells, typically lymphocytes, in the discrete tissue masses, then it is called as lymphoma. Here the blood and bone marrow is not involved. Okay, now this is the basic histology. This is the basic histology and flowchart, how the B cells develop. Now, you all know that precursor B cells develop in the bone marrow. Bone marrow shows progenitor B cells, which will develop into pre-B cells and immature B cells. These then travel through the blood and to the lymphoid organs. Now, in the lymphoid organs, these B cells, either they will develop into naive B cells, or they will go in the parafollicular area and develop mantle cell. These cells only goes into the follicular germinal centers, and they will develop into centrocytes, centroblast and centrocytes. These are the large cells. You can easily see the tentacles here. These are the follicular dendritic cells. These are present in the germinal centers, so that the polarization of the lymphoid follicular germinal center is maintained. Now, after this, these centrocytes develop into either mature lymphocytes, or either into the, when they are antigenically activated, they will develop into plasma cells to release the antibodies, or they will develop into mammary B cells. So you have to remember always these two differentiation, precursor B cells and peripheral mature B cells, because according to these cell types lymphomas will develop. Different type of lymphomas develop from different type of cells. These are the single cells, but at the stage, at which stage they are maturing, on the basis of that lymphomas will be classified and will be named. So these are the B cell neoplasms, precursor B cell neoplasms, when they develop from the precursor cells, they are called as lymphoblastic leukemias. When they develop from the perifollicular area cells, then they will develop into mantle cell lymphoma. Here, this you can easily identify. Now, if they are developed from the germinal center cells, either from the centroblasts, centrocytes, then they will develop follicular lymphomas, Burkitt, DLBC and Hodgkin's lymphoma. And if they develop from the plasma cell, then plasma cell neoplasm are there. If they develop from the perifollicular area cells, then marginal zone and mold lymphomas will develop. This is the flowchart for T cell differentiation. You know, T cells are developed in the thymus. The progenitor T cells or prothymocyte develops in bone marrow, and which will go into thymus and they will mature there. Here, if the lymphomas develop from these premature cells, then they are called as T lymphoblastic lymphomas. Now, these mature T cells, when they go through the blood to the peripheral lymphoid organs like spleen, mucosa, blood, skin, and they will develop different type of lymphomas there. So this is the cell, naive T cell and CD4 type and CD8 type, then they will develop into different types of cells. So if this area is involved in the lymphoma formation, then they will be called as peripheral mature T cell and NK cell lymphomas. I have already told you NK cells are neutral types of cells which does not present any antigen like B or T cell. Okay, this is the basic photograph to show you how does a lymphoma look like. Now this is the normal lymphonode architecture. Here you can easily identify cortex, medulla and the paracortical area. Now in the cortex there are many follicles, germinal centers are being seen in the follicles. This is the germinal center, this is the germinal center, this is the parafollicular area and this is the medullary area. In the medullary area there are sinuses, majority of sinuses are there. Blood filled sinuses is there, but whenever the lymph node is involved by a lymphoma, then what happens, this architecture, this normal architecture is lost. Only we can see just a sheets of cells. These cells appear to be monomorphic and the complete effacement of lymph node architecture is being there. Another important point to see which indicates lymphoma is, you can see, you can appreciate the lymph node capsule here. This is the lymph node capsule, but the cells here are infiltrating in this fat area in the capsule and going outside. So whenever this massive extra nodal spread outside the lymph node is seen, then also it denotes a lymphoma. Now classification, this is the newer WHO classification. You must be remember these five entities: precursor B cell neoplasm, peripheral B cell neoplasm, precursor T cell, peripheral T cell and NK cell, and the other one is Hodgkin's lymphoma. The above 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, ABCD comes in the non-Hodgkin's lymphoma, and other than the Hodgkin's lymphoma, all comes in the non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. Now, in detail, this precursor B cell neoplasm is divided into two types, B cell ALL and T cell ALL. Okay, when they are involving the blood, then they will be called leukemia. When they are only present in the lymph nodes or the peripheral organs, then they are called as lymphomas. Now this is the vast, very long classification of peripheral B cell neoplasm. Here you can easily remember the names because of the type of the cell and the location of the cell where it is located in the lymph node. So it is chronic lymphocytic leukemia or small lymphocytic lymphoma. Here chronic means long standing, lymphocytic means small lymphocytes are seen. When it is seen in the blood, then it is called leukemia. When it is seen in only lymph node, then lymphomas. Next is B cell pro lymphocytic leukemia. Again, pro lymphocyte proliferation is there. other lymphoplasmacytic lymphoma. As the name suggests, there is proliferation of lymphoid cells as well as the plasma cells. The plasma cytoid cells, they will consist of both mature and immature cells. This next is marginal zone lymphoma. Again, the marginal zone, that is polyfollicular area. The periphery of the follicles of the germinal centers, follicles are marginal areas, and from there if the tumor develops, then it is called as marginal zone lymphoma. It may be nodal, it may be extranodal. Then mantle cell lymphomas, again if it develops from the mantle cell. Then follicular lymphoma develops from the follicles, and it will present as a follicular subtype only. There will be formation of many follicles. Marginal zone lymphoma already covered up, hairy cell, plasmacytoid and others. Now, other one is the Hodgkin's lymphoma. Now, what is Hodgkin's lymphoma? This is another entity than non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. Why this is so? Because of the histogenesis. Hodgkin's lymphoma develops, these are the neoplasms of RS cells, Reed-Sternberg cells. So, they have a different histogenesis than non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. So, we call them as Hodgkin's lymphoma. It is divided into two subtypes, classical and nodular lymphocytic predominant. Classical is being divided into four subtypes. Now, this is the gross picture. You can easily see these are the multiple lymph nodes are there. They are adherent to each other. They are of large size and their cut surface is homogeneous gray white. So you can easily identify this accordingly, that this is being involved by lymphomas of any type it may be, which can be seen by microscopy. But on grossly, if large lymph nodes are there, they are adhered to each other, homogeneous cut surface is there, then you will call them as lymphomas. Here is the large view of the same picture. Now, what about the Hodgkin's lymphoma classification? Okay. I told you about the four subtypes there. Now, in Hodgkin's lymphoma, lymphocytic predominance, nodular sclerosis, mixed cellularity and lymphocytic rich. This is the four subtypes of classical Hodgkin's lymphoma. In this lymphocytic predominance, as the name suggests, there will be lot of lymphocytes. See, you can see here lymphocytes are very large in number. In nodular sclerosis, there will be sclerosis and nodular formations will be there. In the cells are being arranged in nodules, which is surrounded by the sclerosing areas. Then mixed cellularity means there is multiple type of cells are there, like eosinophils, plasma cells and others. Then lymphocytic rich means again lymphocytes are very high. This lymphocytic predominance one is the nodular lymphocyte predominant, which comes in the other than the classical Hodgkin's lymphoma. As you all remember this thing, the classification, it is being divided into two subtypes, classical and nodular lymphocyte predominant. So this nodular lymphocyte predominant is this one. Okay, this one. Lymphocyte predominant, in which lymphocytes are very high in number. But the difference between lymphocytic predominance and other subtypes are key. In lymphocytic predominance, RS cells are not there. These L and H cells are there, that is Langerhans histiocytic cells are there. While in nodular sclerosis, mixed cellularity, lymphocyte rich and other, there is presence of RS cells. I will tell you what are RS cells in the further slides. So, what are Hodgkin's lymphoma? Hodgkin lymphoma are those lymphomas with where there is neoplastic giant cells present called Reed-Sternberg cells. So, proliferation of these cells is there. These are called as RS cells in short. You have to remember the name Reed-Sternberg cells. So, this is the Hodgkin's lymphoma development from the Reed-Sternberg cells. Also, because of these cells release factors which cause accumulation of reactive lymphocytes, macrophages and granulocytes. So, you all know that if whenever there is a polymorphous population, whenever other cells are also seen in a lymphoma, then you will think of the Hodgkin's lymphoma. Now, this is the histopathological view. This you can easily see, a large cell is there with two nucleus, one and two. You have to identify, this is the cell membrane, this is the cytoplasm, pale colored. This one nucleus, this is another nucleus, and in this nucleus, this is a large prominent eosinophilic nucleoli in the nucleus. So nucleus is looking empty here. Here also it is looking empty, so it is called as owl's eye nuclei. So two mirror image of each other and owl's eye nuclei. So these are the two nucleus with prominent eosinophilic nucleoli. You have to remember this word, RS cell, Reed-Sternberg cells, and their description also. They are 45 micrometer in size with multiple single bilobe nuclei with a large inclusion like nucleolus is seen in them. This is the inclusion like nucleolus. This pink colored nucleolus is seen. You have to remember this word also, transcription factor NFK beta, because this is very important in activation, because in this is related with the pathogenesis of Hodgkin's lymphoma, because this transcription factor turns on genes which promote the growth of RS cells. Now this is the microscopic picture. Again, I have here different types of cells are seen here. I will show you the cells. See, first and foremost, you see that there are different type of cells. There are cells with small nucleus, cytoplasm is pink in color. There are large nucleus with large nucleoli. There are some cells which are showing here with the spindling here. This is the spindle cell. So there is a polymorphous population. Different type of cells are there. So you, whenever there is new architecture effacement with different type of cells, then you will think of the Hodgkin's lymphoma. Sorry. Now these are the typical RS cells. Here you can see large cell with two nucleus, and this is the nucleoli, prominent nucleoli in them. This is the single large cell with prominent nucleoli. This is called as Hodgkin cell. So single mononuclear cell is their RS cell, then it is called as Hodgkin's cell. This is the lacunar cells. You as you remember, nodular sclerosing type, they are RS cells take the form of lacunar cells. Here the nucleus is present in a lacuna. Now this is the popcorn cell. Here you can see multinucleated cell. Now in the background you can easily identify eosinophil. See here bilobe structure with pink eosinophilic cytoplasm. So this is the eosinophil. You can easily appreciate here. This is also eosinophils are there. Now plasma cells may be there. Yeah, see, this one is the plasma cell with cartwheel appearance and eccentric nuclei. So eccentric nucleus is there. So these are the plasma cells. Here also you can identify plasma cells. So polymorphous population in the background, and along with this, RS cells, either bilobe or mononuclear or lacunar type or popcorn cell may be present. So, and along with the other features of lymphoma, then you will consider it as a non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. Okay, thank you everyone. Now I have completed the lecture. Thanks.